now?
Well, it's in, as the American commanders call it, a dire but not yet hopeless state. However, it's hard to see how the war is not in an intractable position. I mean, there's a lot of activity, but there's no progress, either politically, economically, or militarily. We're now entering the fifth year of this war. We've seen more than 3,000 American combat deaths and non-hostile deaths, and we've seen more than 20,000 American wounded. Yet what's been achieved? I mean, is there a true democratic state either in existence or even emerging?
Supporters of the war, Vice President Cheney says that there are successes, and they point to the democratic elections that have been held.
Right. On the surface, yes, they are successes. There's one of the most progressive constitutions in the Arab world in place in Iraq. But what's the reality? What's the effect? What's it like for the ordinary Iraqi on the street? And their common retort is, if this is democracy, then we'd rather have the old ways. I mean, this is your freedom. I mean, look at their lives. I mean, look at how their daily life is racked with violence. People are being ethnically cleansed from their neighbourhoods. You can't send your children to school for fear of crossing ethnic lines. Bodies are showing up in the streets every day. Death squads are roaming the streets at night. And for Sunnis, these death squads come in the dead of night in legitimate police or army uniforms, showing legitimate identification, saying, you must come with us.
So the focus is on Baghdad. Is there a cost that will be paid because of that?
Absolutely. This focus on Baghdad that we've seen evolve in American strategy over the last 12 to 18 months does not come without a price. While you're pouring all your attentions, or the thrust of your attentions, militarily, politically, and economically, into the capital, the question is, what's happening beyond the city? So while you focus on Baghdad, part of the cost of that is that over here in Anbar province, that's suffering for want of troops and a real thrust of effort, Al-Qaeda, which the Marines themselves say more or less politically owns this part of the country, is becoming stronger. Focusing on Baghdad has given Al-Qaeda the oxygen it has needed to grow.
They are planning on sending several thousand more troops to
4,000 more troops to Al-Anbar. But like the country overall, again, that's just a drop in the bucket. Part of the other price to be paid for the focus on Baghdad is that here in the south, you have entrenched Iranian influence, as we see through the control of the Iraqi militias. By and large, the militias own the south. And what that means is that Iran's influence is greatest there. Now, whilst it is a much more stable place in the south, and American commanders are quick to point that the levels of violence there are minimal, the reality is, as Sunnis often charge, is that veneer of stability has been achieved through an accommodation with the militias and essentially with Iran. You let them control it, you give power to them, and on the surface, it will look good.
See, we talk about this new strategy. You say, though, there's really not that much new about it.
Now, what we're seeing is the old becoming new again. I mean, in many ways, this is, again, staying the course. There's no radical shift in strategy. I mean, let's, for example, look at the troop numbers. We're seeing what they're calling a surge. Now, that doesn't suggest in any way a complete overhaul of strategy. It's talking about an enhancement. So 21,500 troops, given the state of the problem, the size of the country and the population, by and large is nothing. That's still a drop in the bucket. And what we're seeing in terms of the actual tactics to be now employed in the capital, Baghdad, sprinkling US troops throughout neighbourhoods, throughout the city, again, is not new. It may be a development for the capital, but we've seen this particular strategy evolve in Iraq with American forces. We first saw it in the northern border town of Talafa, an Al-Qaeda gateway. We've since seen that adopted and enhanced in western city of Ramadi, the true Al-Qaeda national headquarters. And we're now seeing it being supplanted in Baghdad. So in many ways, this is something that we've seen coming to life again and being described as a new strategy, as President Bush called it in the State of the Union address.
More insight from Michael Ware coming up on each of the four wars that he says are now being fought in Iraq, plus Michael's brush with death.
Covering the story is dangerous enough without nearly becoming the story.
These men intercepted my vehicle and with grenades with the pins pulled so that they were live, hauled me from the car, and with my own video camera, they were preparing to film my execution.
The story Michael Ware lived to tell, his insider's view of the war, when the special edition of 360, Iraq, the Hidden Wars, continues.
At Johnson & Johnson, we understand the importance of a nurse's touch.
Checking the baby and listening to his heart and, you know, thinking maybe you don't hear something quite right and alerting the doctor. I am one of the few people who knows what to do in that kind of situation.
A nurse's touch can touch the world.
I know I make a difference. It's my niche in life. It's where I belong.
Nurses, we need you more than ever. A message of caring from Johnson & Johnson.
Hello, I'm a Mac.
And I'm a PC.
Are you going in for a checkup?
Well, I'm upgrading to Vista today, which is great, but I get a little nervous when they mess around with my insides.
Well, what do you mean? Isn't it just straightforward?
Not really. Like a lot of PCs, I have to update my graphics card, my memory. If I want the premium package, I need a faster processor. It's major surgery.
I'm sorry about that.
Listen, Mac, if I don't come back, I want you to have my peripherals.
Oh, come on. PC, you're not good. Speaking of peripherals...
Yep, we got a whole aisle here dedicated to fiber pills, you got fiber powder, fiber gum. But if you just have one bowl of these all-brand yogurt bites, you get these crunchy flakes. Oh, these little yogurt thingies are really good too. Plus, you're going to get three times the amount of fiber that you get in the leading fiber supplement. They put yogurt in those pills? No. No.
All-brand yogurt bites. Have your fiber and eat it too.
This is Jack Thomas. Today, someone almost brought Jack something to eat. Someone almost drove him to a shelter. And someone else almost brought him a warm blanket. And Jack Thomas? Well, he almost made it through the night.